1916. The Eastern Front is locked in a stalemate. After several failed and expensive campaigns, the Russians were unwilling to attack, while the Austro-Hungarians were content to hold the line. Germany battled the Allies in France and Belgium, but the Allies needed to attack the Central Powers on both fronts. So the under-resourced Russian army was pressed to find new methods to break down the superior Habsburg forces that had long resisted them.
Мы копаем наши траншеи далеко на ничейной земле, некоторые лишь в 70 метрах от их линии обороны. Генерал Брусилов сказал нам, что элемент неожиданности бывает опаснее винтовки.
Капитан отобрал взвод самых сильных и храбрых наших бойцов. Наш маленький отряд должен будет штурмовать три вражеских окопа еще до прекращения артобстрела.
Россия, наша великая страна, могла прокормить целый мир, а нам не хватает еды. И не только еды, одежды, топлива, обуви. Как мы будем воевать без обуви?
We have taken objective Butter.
Enemy soldier! There! There! An enemy soldier! One of their soldiers sighted! Over there!
We have
one
lost
of them.
Objective Butter.
Hate to say this, but we've lost the objective!
I can see one of their soldiers! Enemy soldier sighted! Sighted! An enemy soldier! Enemy soldier sighted! That's an enemy soldier! That is soldier!
Them. win, we lose. We still live. The dream of victory is not over. We have one last chance to see these Habsburg dogs to their graves. Stand up, soldiers. Stand up and fight again.
We are being reinforced with an armored train.
And our shock troops.
Hey!
taken Objective Butter.
We've taken the objective!
Clear the sector from enemy presence.
To the scout! See there! A medic! Spare ammo, anyone!
Losing objective. Thank you. have lost objective apples. We have taken objective apples. Soldiers remain.
Passion for our motherland will never stop, and you will fight again. Only the dead have seen the end of this war.
By the beginning of 1916, it was becoming increasingly clear that Russia could no longer sustain the losses from several failed operations while maintaining loyalty to the autocratic and ever more dysfunctional monarchy of Tsar Nicholas II. If the Austro-Hungarians had managed to halt the first Brusilov advance, inflicting further wounds on Russia, it is likely that anger amongst the people at home would have ignited the revolution immediately, leading to the Bolsheviks pulling Russia out of the war before the winter set in, a huge blow to the Allied alliance.